I'm Ben Scholl, and I'm in the Fitzpatrick Lab, and we study the properties of cortical neurons, in particular the visual cortex. A lot of my research is involved with trying to understand how individual neurons receive thousands of inputs from other neurons and sort of the organization and function of those particular inputs. We know that the brain is dynamic and that we know that neurons can be connected to thousands, if not 10,000s of other neurons, but we don't have a really good understanding as to how all those connections are put together and also how those connections might change during development or, for example, during learning. For me, the best part about being in a lab and working in science is I can design the experiments that I want to do, I can build the techniques, I can decide when I want to do them, I can come in and I have free rein to do this however I want to do it. And what that's really wonderful because it allows you to go down a particular path. So it just allows you to follow that path and go try to answer that question or try to solve that problem. I was born in Oregon on the West Coast, in Portland, Oregon. I didn't always want to be a scientist. My father was a scientist, and both my father and my mother were teachers. And when I went to college, I had no idea what I wanted to do. I actually, for a while, I wanted to be an astronaut like most people, and then I thought about medicine for a long time. And so for many years, actually, I was pre-med. To a certain extent, I almost wanted to be an engineer. I decided, I should get some lab experience. And the only position that I found was actually with a neuroscientist. And this neuroscientist was his Dr. Mike Weir, and he was absolutely fantastic. And that's kind of where I decided, like, oh, I could really do this. Like, this is really fun. The hardest thing about being a scientist is being able to analyze and think critically, to be able to think critically about a problem and or about some piece of research. I think the other aspect of being a scientist is also being stubborn. Because, to be honest, what a lot of people don't realize when they go into grad school is that basically nothing works. So you're going to do something, you know, and you're going to do something and you're going to try to do something, and 90% of the time that you do it, it's not going to work. And so some people would be disgruntled by that and they would give up, and other people would just keep on going until it did work that 10% of the time. I would hope that my research here is successful, and I'd like to try to understand a little bit about how neurons are connected a little bit better. I want to be a professor, because I want to be doing research, but I also want to be teaching students again and be in the classroom and be educating a new generation of students. So here we have a single process of an individual neuron, and we can see that it extends across this image, but also branches here, and you can see it going off in the distance. There are two really important aspects about being in academia. One is you have to find something you love doing. You have to find that particular technique or particular area of science which you really enjoy. The second is that you just have to be persistent. Usually what we say is that the last 10% of any project is 90% of the work. So the question is, when you get 90% of the way done with your work, with your project, with your story, can you finish that last 10%? Some people can and some people can't, but being able to learn how to do that is immensely helpful in graduate school, in science, and actually in a lot of aspects of life and academia.